Imagine, if you can, that you're a pro-choice obstetrician gynecologist like I was. Your patient today is 24 weeks pregnant, measured last menstrual period as obstetricians typically do. At 24 weeks from last menstrual period, her uterus is 2 finger breadths above her umbilicus. If you could see her baby, which would be easy on an ultrasound, that baby would be as long as your hand plus a half, from head to rump, not counting the legs. Your patient has been feeling her baby kick for the last month or more, and now she's asleep on an operating room table, and you're there to help her with her problem pregnancy. The first task is to remove the laminaria that had earlier been placed in the cervix, the opening to the uterus, to dilate it sufficiently to allow the procedure that you are about to perform. With that accomplished, direct your attention to the surgical instruments arranged on the right. The first instrument you'll need is a 14 French suction catheter. I brought one along so you don't have to imagine it. It's about 9 inches long, it's clear plastic, and there's an opening through the center of it. Picture yourself, if you can, taking this instrument and introducing it through the cervix and instructing your circulating nurse to turn on the suction machine. What you'll see is pale yellow fluid running through this, through the tubing into the suction machine. That was the amniotic fluid that was there originally to protect the baby. You're next going to need a Sofra clamp. It's about 13 inches long, it's stainless steel, and the jaw on this is composed of rows of sharp teeth. You introduce this instrument blindly and start pulling off limbs. Feel yourself grabbing and pulling hard, and I do mean hard, and out pops an arm about that long, which you put down next to you, followed that by a leg just as long. And then you tear out the intestine, the spine, heart and lungs. Difficult part of the procedure is the head, which is about the size of a plum. You know you got it right if you've, again, this is blind, but you know you've got it right if your instrument's spread about as far as it can go, and you've got a hold of this, and you know you did it right if you crush down a white material that runs out of the cervix. That was the baby's brains. Then you can pull out skull pieces. Many times a little face will come back and stare back at you. Congratulations, you just successfully performed a D&E abortion. And if you think that doesn't hurt, if you believe that that isn't an agony for this child, please think again.